Hi, this is Amber from the A-Team. We're going to talk today about using your webcam in YouTube to be able to capture some webcam footage that you can use for flipped instruction. So the first thing that we want to make sure we've done is checked our settings, and we talked about this in the last video. But once you're on the account tab, you're going to want to click on channel status and features. When you're here, you're going to want to make sure you're on the channel tab and on the feature eligibility tab. And what we're looking at are the features that require phone verification. Because we're going to do live streaming, we need to make sure that we have this enabled. This is also the feature that allows for custom thumbnails and the longer than 15-minute videos. So you're going to want to make sure this is enabled. So if that's enabled, we can proceed to what we're going to do. Now, at the very top of your screen, you'll notice I have a little go live button and I also have the upload button, but this is also available in your create menu where you can go live. So either way, whether you click from here or here, I'm going to go ahead and click go live so we can take a look at some of the things. Now, the first thing you may be asked is if you want to use a webcam video or not. There may be a menu that comes up that says, do you want to do your stream now or later? And if it says now or later, when you're doing your webcam, you're wanting to do it now, not later, because you're sitting here, you're wanting to create that video, so you would choose now. So what you're going to do is make sure you're on the webcam tab on the left, and you're going to put a title. So I'm going to call this Welcome Students, because I'm going to make a welcome video to introduce myself to my students. I do like to make sure that it's private until I am sure that it's ready to publish. So that's something that I'm going to always choose as private, because right now I'm just going to live stream with myself because I'm just using it for the purpose of recording, not for showing to the world. Also, you're going to have to make that decision. Is it made for kids or not? This one is made for kids. So the great thing is you get to choose it as you make it. The reason it's asking you this is when you record a webcam live stream, it automatically stores it in YouTube. So you do have to do that step for COPPA and make sure that you indicate if it's student friendly or not. Also, I'm going to click on more options because this is important to make sure that you choose the correct camera and the correct microphone. I'm actually going to change my microphone to the one I'm using now, which is my Zone Wireless, and then I'm going to go ahead and click next. So now that I'm here, I'm going to get that countdown. So what that's doing is it's creating a stream preview. It's going to show you what it's going to look like. So you also can upload a custom thumbnail so that the live has a thumbnail. Well, I'm not going to use it for publishing live to the web. I'm going to use it for recording, but I do need to retake this thumbnail because I look like I'm asleep. So I'm going to do retake thumbnail. So there's my thumbnail. Also, if I need to change something about it, I can click edit and I'll go and be able to get those same edits. So you notice this gives me time to see what it looks like before I go live. So this is actually a really great feature is the stream preview. So I'm going to go ahead and click on go live and I'm going to show you how we will go about recording. So I'm going to click on go live and then I'll get my countdown. Hi everyone, it's so nice to see you. I wanted to give a little bit of introduction to myself. My name is Miss Garvey. I'm going to be your teacher this year, and there's some things that you should know about me, blah blah blah. And so this is how we would record the video. So now let's go about showing you some things that are here while we're here. So you would actually make your video. One of the things that people make the mistake of is staring at themselves instead of staring at the camera. So one of the things that's just a best practice is to make sure that you're actually looking at the camera lens so that you feel like you're connecting to your students. But I do want to take a few moments and show you around this live stream window so you can see some of the things you have available to you. So at the top, you're going to see live, and whenever that's red, it means you're live. You're streaming, it's recording, it's going to go onto YouTube. Then we have our countdown, our count up that shows you how long you have been recording. So now I've been recording approximately 56 seconds. It also shows you how many people are live. And if you're recording this for flipped instruction, you're only ever going to see one because you're not going to ask someone to join. You're just using this just for the recording purposes. You'll also have this little likes thing, but again, nobody's in here with me, so I'm not going to get any likes. So a couple of other things that I want to show you at the bottom. You're going to see your audio. So as you speak, this is kind of your audio to see how loud it is. There's also your microphone button. If for some point in the middle of your thing you needed to mute, now I'm muted. So that's a way to do that. Also, you have your arrow button, which enables you to share your live stream. Again, I'm not going to need to do that because I'm not sharing it with anyone. I'm not publishing it actually to be live. I'm just using it for recording. There's also an edit button in the right-hand corner that you can use to change your description or any of this information. Again, I don't need to do that because I'm literally just using my camera to record. So when I'm finished, and that's literally all I have access to, I'm going to go ahead and click end live stream. So I want you to see what happens when you end that live stream. Your stream will stop immediately. You'll no longer be live. Well, good. I want to end it. So what it tells you is the duration of the video. And then what it gives you is you can dismiss this, but you may want to go to studio and edit. So I'm going to go ahead and click edit in studio so that you can see what happens here. It opens up in studio editor. Now the reason I wanted to show you this is because if you are wanting to do any editing of your video, perhaps you stumbled a little bit on your words in the beginning, or it took you a while to kind of stop the video, you can trim some things in your video. It may take some time before the video actually pulls in, so this is something that you might come back and edit later, but I want to make sure that I show you these really cool tools. So now my video has loaded, and I can see this is my entire stream here. So, you know, I did some talking to you, explaining things, so if I wanted to cut out what I'd done, I can actually start playing, and let's see.
Hi.
So I want to make sure that this part in the beginning is trimmed out. So if I click trim, I can actually drag my playhead to where I want it to be and then trim to that. So I'm going to trim there.
You should know about me, blah, blah, blah.
Okay. So let's say that's the end of that. So now if I want to trim off the rest, I can drag this back here all the way to here. And so that's going to be my final trim.
Hi, everyone. It's so nice to see you. I wanted to get...
And so after you preview it and you see you've cut off the end, you've cut off the beginning, you've cut off the end, then you can click save. Are you sure that you're wanting to save this? Yes. And so it's being processed. And so it should go to a much shorter amount of time because I've cleared a lot out of it. So it does take some time for it to edit, but I can click back and kind of see. Now I do want to show you that once you're on this channel content area, you're used to seeing where your uploads are. Well, all your live streams are going to be on the live tab. So if you come to your channel content and you don't see it, don't panic. Click on your live. And these are ones that are scheduled, but down here are live replays, and you can see that it's processing still because I've made some of those changes. But when it's finished and you're ready to share it, you're going to get your video link here. So you can copy that link, you can share it in Google Classroom, you can share it via email, whatever way you communicate that to your students, and you can keep making these videos. So this is a way to be able to not only create your video, do some light editing, and have something stored on YouTube. Now, all I've got to remember, however, is that if I'm now ready and I've done my editing, I'm going to need to change this visibility to unlisted so that I can then post it on Google Classroom or send it in email or whatever format so that people can see it. So this is just a super easy way to be able to create some content using your webcam and using YouTube to create some flipped instruction. Hopefully, this has helped you see how to use YouTube and your webcam to create some really cool flipped instruction videos.